Hello and welcome to the Structural Guide platform. In this video, I am going to discuss GATE 2014 question paper for a structure subject. Beginning with first question from a structure subject, the question is, the maximum bending moment in a simply supported beam of 8 meter span subjected to a UDL of 20 kN per meter inclusive of its self weight over the entire span is. So the span of the beam is 8 meter and it is simply supported, right? So this is simply supported beam of a span 8 meter and subjected to a UDL of 20 kN per meter, right? So what will the bending moment diagram? Bending moment diagram for this beam will be like this, and the maximum bending moment will occur at the center and the magnitude is equals to WL square by 8. So the maximum bending moment is equals to WL square by 8. In this case W is 20 and L is 8 meter by 8, and it is equals to 160 kilonewton meter. Suppose you forgot the formula, then how will you proceed? Since this beam is symmetric, so the reaction will be same. Suppose this is A and this is B, so VA and VB, and that is equals to 20 into 8, the total load by 2. So this is equals to 80 kilonewton. So the reaction is equals to 80 kilonewton, right? So for the case of UDL, the maximum bending moment occurs at mid span. So take the moment about the mid span. So the moment M, suppose this section is 1 1, so the moment about 1 1 is equals to, I am taking from the left side, so from the left side there is one force 80 kilonewton and one downward load, that is UDL. So the moment of this force VA is equals to VA plus into L by 2, right? VA into L by 2. This is L by 2 and this is also L by 2. So the moment about 1 1 from the left side is equals to plus VA. Why plus? Because VA will produce the rotation in clockwise direction, right? So VA into L by 2, and the UDL, that is minus W into L by 2 into L by 4. W into L by 2 into L by 4. So VA 80 into L by 2, 8 by 2 minus W 20 into L by 2, 8 by 2 into 8 by 4. So this is equals to 320 minus 160, that is 160 kilonewton meter. So it is very easy to calculate if you remember the formula. The formula is, the maximum bending moment in case of UDL is equals to WL square by 8. Remember one more thing, the maximum bending moment in case of point load, this is simply supported. Suppose this is a point load P acting at a distance A from the left support. This is A and B. The maximum moment that will occur under the load is equals to PAB by L. So remember this formula. Suppose this load P is acting at the midpoint, So in this case, A equals to B equals to L by 2. So in this case, the maximum moment is equals to PL by 4. This is for the point load. Moving to the next question. The next question is, the most important property of concrete in its fresh state is? The correct answer for this question is workability. What is workability? I have already discussed in earlier video. Click on I button to know what is workability. So the compressive strength, tensile strength and the elastic modulus, this is the property of hard concrete. This is the property of hard concrete. Generally, compressive strength is determined after 28 days. The next question from structural subject is, an element constructed at intervals along the length of a wall to stabilize it against overturning is buttress. Buttress is very popular to its use in retaining wall. Retaining wall is very prone to the lateral load. So the buttress will provide the stability against the overturning. And the barrel vault and the squinch arch is not related to, this is not related to the stabilization of wall. The pilaster is basically an architectural element, not a structural element. Architectural element, and this is used only for the ornamentation function. The next question is, a single span simply supported reinforced concrete beam size is 250 mm by 480 mm effective depth is subjected to a concentrated load of 120 kN at its mid span. Neglecting the self weight of the beam, the nominal shear strength at the support section is. So this is again a question of simply supported beam subjected to a point load. So this is simply supported beam and it is subjected to a point load at mid span. The concentrated load is 120 kN and the span is. So in this question, it is a single span simply supported beam. So assume the length of the span is L meter. Since it is symmetric, so the reaction at A and B, reaction at the support, will be equals to the half of the concentrated load, that is 60 kN and 60 kN. So shear force diagram in this case will be like this. At A, shear force is equals to 60 kN and at B, it is also equals to 60 kN. So in this question, it is asking the nominal shear stress at the support section. So here, the shear force at supports is equals to 60 kN. So shear stress is equals to shear force upon area, right? So shear force equals to 60 kN, so 60 into 1000 Newton upon area, that is cross sectional area, 250 by 480, so 250 by 480. This is equals to 4 by 8, that means 0.5 Newton per mm square, right? So the shear stress is equals to shear force upon area, so you will get the shear stress. Looking into the next question, the next question is, assuming full compaction, strength of concrete is inversely proportional to. Remember one point, the strength of concrete is directly related to, the strength of concrete is directly related to the water cement ratio, right? Not the water sand ratio, not the water plasticizer ratio, not the water course aggregate ratio. It is directly related to the water cement ratio, and the relation is inversely proportional. Strength is inversely proportional water cement ratio. Remember one more point, the strength of the concrete is also related to the sand to cement ratio, or I can say it is directly proportional to the cement to sand ratio, right? Moving to the next question. The next question is, if yield stress of steel is 415 MPa, then strain in tensile reinforcement at the limit state of collapse shall be at least, and the data for Young modulus is given, 2 × 10⁵ MPa. So the question is asking about the strain in the tensile reinforcement of the RCC. Suppose this is singly reinforced concrete and this is the neutral axis. The strain diagram in limit state is like this. Strain diagram is linear, right? The maximum strain in the compression fiber is equals to 0.0035 according to the IS 456, and the maximum strain in tensile reinforcement is equals to 0.002 plus 0.87 Fy upon ES, where ES equals to Young modulus of steel. So the strain in tensile reinforcement is equals to 0.002 plus 0.87 Fy upon ES. In this question, yield stress of steel is given, that is 415 Newton per mm square, and ES is given, 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square. So now you can calculate the strain, and that is equals to 0.002 plus 0.87 415 upon 2 × 10⁵. So you will get the answer, right? The next question is, a load of 30 kN is applied vertically downward at the free end of the cantilever of a span 5 m. If the elastic modulus is 30 GPa and the section is 0.3 m by 0.6 m, then the elastic deflection in mm will be. So the question is asking about the deflection of a cantilever beam subjected to a point load at the free end. Suppose this is L and the point load is P, then the deflection at the free end, so this is A and B, so the deflection at B, it is equals to PL cube by 3EI. So you have to remember this formula. You have to remember this formula to solve this numerical. So deflection at B equals to PL cube by 3EI, where E equals to Young modulus, that is given 30 GPa, that is 30 × 10�³ MPa, and MPa is eventually equals to Newton per mm square. So I in this case is the moment of inertia about the neutral axis. So I is equals to 300 × 600 cube by 12. The I for the rectangular section is BD cube by 12, So I equals to 300 into 600 cube by 12. P, the point load that is given 30 kilonewton. So I am converting it into newton, so 30,000 newton. And the span that is given 5 meter. The question is asking elastic deflection in mm. So I am converting all terms in newton and mm. So L equals to 5 meter, that is 5,000 mm. Now put all this value in this formula. Delta B is equals to PL cube by 3EI, where P is equals to 30,000 into L cube 5,000 cube by 3 into E, 30 into 10 power 3 into I, that is 300 into 600 cube by 12. So by solving this, you will get the deflection, right? You will get the deflection. I am getting it 7.71 mm. In the calculation of deflection, you have to remember the some standard formula. This is the some standard results. For deflection, right? So first type is the cantilever beam which subjected to point load at the free end, and the maximum deflection is equals to PLQ by 3I. This is deflection and this is slope. So slope is equals to PL square by 2EI and the deflection PLQ by 3I. So second case is the cantilever beam subjected to a UDL. In this case, the deflection is equals to WL to the power 4 upon ATI. Third case is of cantilever beam subjected to a moment at the free end. So in this case, the deflection is equals to ML square upon 2EI. Fourth case, it is a simply supported beam and it is subjected to a point load at its mid span. In this case, the maximum deflection, that is equals to PL cube by 48EI. PL cube by 48EI. And in case of simply supported subjected to the UDL, the maximum deflection is equals to 5 by 384 WL to the power 4 upon EI. So try to remember all the standard results. So now looking into the last question of the GATE 2014 question paper, the question is, a solid straight steel rod of diameter 100 mm is bent in single curvature into a circular arc by a moment of 50 kilonewton meter that is applied at its end. If elastic modulus E is given, the radius of curvature of the arc will be, right? So it is asking about a solid straight steel which is initially a straight member. Under the moment, it will bend like circular arc, right? So what will be the radius of curvature? So this is the radius of curvature R. So apply the flexural formula. This formula is very important. Flexural formula, that is M upon I is equals to F upon Y is equals to E upon R. So in this formula, M is equals to the bending moment, I is the moment of inertia, F is the bending stress, and Y is the location where bending stress is desired. E is the elastic modulus of the material and R is the radius of curvature. So in this formula, the M is given, I is known, and I is equals to pi by 64 into d to the power 4 in case of circular cross section, and E is given. So you can easily calculate the value of R, So R is equals to EI upon M. R is equals to EI upon M. So E, that is given 2 into 10 to the power 5. I is given, that is pi by 64 d to the power 4, pi by 64 into d to the power 4. Dimension is given, 100 mm diameter, 100 to the power 4 upon moment, and that is also given 50 kilonewton meter. So 50 into 10 to the power 6, right? So I am converting it into Newton mm. So by calculating this, you will get the curvature in mm, that is 19625 mm, right? So remember this formula. This is very important formula, flexural formula. If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe. Thank you.